waking up to another light. No more sorrow and no more night. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now. Burning bright, cause we're not ashamed. Got a world to illuminate. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now.
Come on, are you ready?
Reminds me who I am.
friends, welcome back. I know. I'm not Tiffany. So she had to go walk Kevin because he had apparently too much energy and he needed to exercise it out. I had no idea that you had to walk stuff animals until today. And now I feel like I have a lot of catching up to do with all of mine. I'm going to be walking them for months. I haven't walked any of them ever. Anyway, I'm not really sure what she usually talks to you about. I know she likes rainbows and unicorns. Is that what you usually talk about? So let's start there.
Hey, Zach.
Who's that?
Hi, I'm Taylor. I'm Tiff's friend. She's out walking Kevin, so I'm here to help out.
Oh, thank goodness. I wasn't doing so well taking her place. Do like people really walk stuffed cats?
Mm-hmm, absolutely they do. I mean, it's kind of funny that you were trying to take Tiff's place. Today's Bible story is all about how David took over being king. Remember David? We've been talking about him for a few weeks now.
Yeah, he's super cool. I love how brave he was. So like, when everyone else was afraid of that giant, he like totally wasn't. Super brave.
Yeah, and even cooler part about that was that we can be brave like David. He wasn't just brave on his own, he was brave because he asked God to be with him and to help him be brave.
Wow. So that means even if we're super scared, if we ask God to help us be brave, he will?
Yep, sure will.
So last week, he got all covered in oil.
Well, not that kind of oil, but he was anointed, yes. That just means that he was chosen by God.
So, what happened after he was chosen? Was he just like automatically king? Like, just like that?
Oh no, there's more to this story, like a lot more. Let's take a look. Tiff gave me this really cool bag while she's walking Kevin.
She does love that bag.
And there's a remote in here somewhere. I just can't seem to...
Oh, that was fast.
God's story, David and Saul. So part of God's story is about two guys named David and Saul. And it begins like this. You may have heard of David before. The little shepherd boy who stood up to the massive warrior Goliath and won. But that isn't the whole story. In fact, that's really only a part of it. The rest of the story starts with a man named Saul. See, God wasn't very happy with Saul, Israel's first king. The people of Israel had begged God's prophet Samuel to give them a king so they could be more like other nations. God warned the Israelites they would regret it, but gave them Saul as their king. And like anyone, King Saul wasn't perfect and soon started to mess up, disobeying God and leading Israel away from him. And that's where our friend David comes in. God wanted a new king to replace Saul, so he sent Samuel to a man named Jesse. Jesse showed Samuel his eldest sons, big and strong men. Samuel thought for sure that one of these impressive boys was to be king, but God had other plans. God told Samuel to find another son, so Jesse brought in little David. Even though David was a little scrawny and had the smelly job of taking care of sheep, God told Samuel to look at more than his appearance. Samuel obeyed and anointed David, God's special way of choosing people. When David was anointed, the good spirit that had been helping Saul rule left him and was replaced with a new spirit that wouldn't leave him alone. Imagine there was a bee buzzing around in your brain that you couldn't do a thing about. That may be what it was like for Saul. Since Saul was going a little crazy, his servants had David, a great harp player, come to the palace and play music to calm the king. Now, one day, David came to bring his brothers, who were working as soldiers, some lunch. What started out as a lunch delivery soon turned into one of the most famous stories in the Bible, where tiny David took down the massive warrior Goliath with a single stone. After this, David was like a famous rock star. In fact, David was so popular that Saul worried people would start thinking David should be king instead. Saul began to try and kill, sending him on dangerous quests where any normal guy would have died, and even threw a spear at his head once. Eventually, things got so bad that Jonathan, Saul's son, who David had become great friends with, helped David escape. David wandered for years trying to stay out of Saul's grasp. Twice, Saul even got so close that David had the opportunity to kill him. But David refused to kill the king in charge. David continued to flee from Saul for years, and without God's blessing, Saul's army was losing to the Philistines. Soon enough, Saul's army had been defeated. Jonathan had died, and the Philistines were now chasing them. Saul was so afraid of capture that he chose to fall on his own sword instead of letting the Philistines catch him. When David heard of Jonathan and Saul's death, he went out and avenged them. And with Saul dead, David returned to Israel and at last took his place as God's new king. And that's the story of David and Saul. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. God made Saul king. Saul disobeyed God. God said he would take the kingdom away from Saul and chose David. David became popular. Saul became fearful of David. David had to run away. David wandered for years. Saul died. David avenged Saul. David took over as Israel's chosen king.
Wow. Just wow. Like, Saul was so awful to David. He really kept trying to kill him.
Yeah. And the cool part is, David had a chance to kill Saul and take over the whole kingdom. But instead, he had mercy on Saul and let him be.
He had mercy? Like, the planet?
No, you're thinking of Mercury.
Oh. Well, then what the heck is mercy?
Mercy is just another word for compassion. Mercy would be like letting someone out of a punishment.
Ah. So, like, when my dad said don't color on the dark with markers, and then I did anyway, but instead of getting punished, he showed me mercy and gave me a towel to clean the dog off.
Yeah, exactly like that. Showing mercy is when you're willing to be kind. Loving and helpful to someone else, even when they don't really deserve it.
Oh, man. I bet there are so many ways to show mercy to someone.
Yeah, there are. But sometimes showing mercy is a little hard to do. Especially when someone doesn't treat us well and needs our forgiveness.
Oh, man. Hey, isn't that what happened in our Bible lesson today? David could have punished King Saul for just treating him just so terribly and awful, but instead, he showed him mercy and let him go free.
Right. And that leads us to our big idea for this week.
Oh, wait a minute. Kevin had it. He had it in a bag. Let me see. Here it is. Oh, man. Kevin needs brushed. Really, really bad.
Well, let's see. Oh, we can show others mercy.
We can show others mercy. Oh, that reminds me. I think I might not have shown much mercy to my friend Eric this morning. He kept stealing the ball when we were playing basketball, and I just got really mad and just left him out there. I think I'm going to have to go apologize for being so angry and, you know, let him know that I forgive him.
Good idea.
All right, well, I'm going to head over there. I'll see you later. Nice meeting you.
You too. Bye. Hey, let's do our memory verse. Stand up. Everybody stand up. Do you remember it? It's Isaiah 41:10. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. One more time, guys. Come on. Isaiah 41:10. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. Woohoo! We did it. Hey, we learned a lot about mercy today. Friends, do you know why it's so important to show mercy? It's important to show mercy because Jesus did. Yeah, Jesus was so good at it. My favorite time was when he showed mercy to one of his disciples named Peter. Take a look. Where's that remote?
Miracle of mercy, Peter. This is Peter.
Heyo! Whoop!
Peter was a fisherman who was called by Jesus.
Hey!
Peter saw the many miracles of Jesus, and he heard all of his teachings. When the time came for Jesus to die and take away the sins of all the world, Jesus had one final meal with his friends. During this meal, Jesus told his followers that the time had come for him to leave them.
Huh?
Peter asked, "Where are you going?" Jesus told him Peter couldn't follow him now.
What?
But that he would follow him later.
Wait a second.
But Peter said, "Why can't I come now? I'm ready to die for you." Jesus said, "Die for me? Peter, before the rooster crows tomorrow morning, you will deny 3 times that you even knew me." Then Jesus and his disciples went to the Mount of Olives so Jesus could pray. Along the way, Jesus told his followers that they would all abandon him.
Uh-oh.
But Peter said, "Even if everyone else leaves you, I never will." Jesus said, "Peter, this very night, before the rooster crows, you will deny 3 times that you even know me." But Peter wouldn't believe it and vowed that he would stay with Jesus until the very end. The other disciples vowed the same.
Yeah, I do.
Later on that night, Jesus was arrested by men sent by the religious teachers and priests. Peter tried to fight for Jesus, and he cut off the ear of one of the guards.
Ow.
But Jesus healed the guard,
huh?
And went quietly with the captors. All the disciples scattered just as Jesus told them they would. The men led Jesus away to the house of the high priest. Peter and another disciple followed them. Peter came to warm himself by their fire.
Hello.
A servant girl noticed him in the firelight.
Huh?
Finally, she said, "This man was one of Jesus' followers."
Oh, ma?
But Peter denied it for the first time. He said, "I don't even know him." After a while, someone else looked at him and said, "You must be one of them."
Oh.
Peter, for a second time, said, "No, I'm not."
Okay.
About an hour later, a man who knew the man whose ear Peter cut off said, "Didn't I see you in the olive grove with Jesus? This must be one of them. He comes from the same place as all of them."
Yeah, you're right.
But Peter said,
"No, no, no.
I don't know what you're talking about." And then Peter heard the crow of the rooster. Jesus turned and looked at Peter. Jesus' words flashed through his mind, and Peter left the courtyard weeping. Then Jesus died and was placed in a tomb. The disciples heard that he had come back from the dead. Peter even saw the empty tomb and believed that Jesus was alive again.
Woo-hoo!
And Jesus appeared to the disciples to show him that he was alive. Some of Jesus' followers were together when Peter said, "I am going fishing."
Okay.
So they all went out to the sea, but caught nothing all night. At dawn, they saw a man standing on the beach.
Oh, hey, over here.
The man called out to them and said, "Have you caught any fish?"
Nope.
The man said, "Throw out your net on the right side and you'll get some."
Okay.
So they did, and they couldn't bring in the net because there were so many fish in it. Then one of the men on the boat said to Peter, "It's Jesus." When Peter heard that it was Jesus, he swam to the shore while the others pulled in the load to the boat. When they got there, they found breakfast waiting for them.
I miss a fish. Got it.
Jesus said, "Come have some breakfast." While they were eating, Jesus asked Peter, "Do you love me?" Peter said, "Yes, you know I love you." So Jesus said, "Then feed my lambs." Then Jesus asked again, do you love me? Peter said again, yes, you know I love you. And Jesus said, then take care of my sheep. And then a third time, Jesus asked Peter, do you love me? Peter was hurt that Jesus asked the question a third time. So he said, you know everything. You know that I love you. So Jesus said one last time, then feed my sheep. And so Peter went on to feed Jesus' sheep by helping establish the church and by writing books that we can now read in the Bible. And though he denied Jesus, he was forgiven. And many came to know the love and forgiveness of Jesus through Peter.
Wow, friends, Jesus is amazing. He really loves us. He had mercy on Peter, even though he betrayed him. And guess what? He has mercy on us all the time. I can think of at least 5 times today where I needed God's mercy. And thankfully, he will always give it to us. If we want to love people the way that Jesus did, we need to show others mercy, just like Jesus had with Peter. And just like David had with Saul. Oh no! Zach left the door open to the car and all of Kevin's snacks were in there. What if those pesky squirrels get to them? I'm gonna be so mad if I have to go to the store again for more of Kevin's snacks. Wait. No, I'll have compassion and forgive Zach for leaving the door open, right? Well, see you next week.
We hope you enjoyed today's experience. Being connected is so important for our kids, and we would love to continue to partner with you and encourage you as a family to stay plugged in throughout this week as well. You can stay connected with Rust City Kids by signing up for our parent email. This will give you access to exclusive content, parent tips, encouragement from our kids' pastors, activities, and much more. You can go to rustcity.church/kids and fill out the quick form to sign up. And while you're signing up, be sure to check out this week's parent guide. It's loaded with questions and activities for you and your kids to do from home and continue to develop your child's relationship with God. Check it out now and have a great week.